Graphene is the sexy new wonder material that seems to have a million and one uses. From thin, flexible screens to solar cells that work when it's raining, people are finding all sorts of applications for this one atom thick sheet of carbon. Now scientists have found another trick to add to graphene's repertoire, making seawater drinkable. Desalination is not a new concept. Israel gets over a quarter of its fresh water from the Mediterranean Sea. But graphene could make the whole process much more efficient. The main technique used for large-scale desalination is called reverse osmosis. Normal osmosis is where water flows across a semi-permeable membrane from areas of low saltiness to areas of higher saltiness. If you were one of those kids who poured salt on slugs, causing them to shrivel up, you know what I'm talking about. Also, dude, not cool. The reverse osmosis used for desalination, however, is when pressure is applied to salt water to force it in the direction it doesn't normally flow, through special membranes to areas of low salinity, separating the H2O and telling the salt, nah, 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 hey, 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 goodbye. Get it? Because sodium is, nah, anyway. This all sounds great, but it's not perfect. Water from desalination is very expensive, costing anywhere from $1,000 to $2,500 per acre foot, which is about the amount of water 10 people use in a year. Generally, it's cheaper to just use less water and recycle the water you do use, but for some particularly dry places, there's no other option. Part of the expense comes from pre-treating the water, but pumping the water through the jelly roll-like plastic membranes uses a lot of energy. Computer models have predicted that if we could use super thin graphene sheets instead of these thicker membranes, the amount of energy needed for reverse osmosis could be reduced anywhere from 15 to 46%. Less energy used for pumping means less expensive water, and that could make a huge difference to people in the world's poorer and drier places. Unfortunately, reality doesn't always cooperate with computer models, and making graphene that can separate water from salt isn't as straightforward as it appears. Researchers found that when their graphene oxide membranes were submerged in water, they swole a little bit. They would still filter nanoparticles, organic molecules, and even larger salts, but the more common salts found in seawater could still get through. And you don't want to drink those because they just lead to more dehydration. That's normal osmosis at work again. But now the same group of researchers have figured out how to prevent the swelling and control the pore size. Now the dissolved salts and the water molecules they bind to can't get through the pores, but the free water molecules can, and do so surprisingly fast, which is a good thing when you're trying to make fresh water as quickly as possible. The researchers hope that their discovery can make desalination much more affordable, which would be a huge boon to poorer, drought-stricken countries who can't afford to build billion-dollar desalination plants. With climate change threatening to make droughts even worse, graphene could do more than just make flexible screens. It could help save lives. Oh, graphene, you're my hero. Special thanks to our sponsor, domain.com. When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. Get 15% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use coupon code SEEKER at checkout. Do you think desalination is the answer to solving drought, or is the problem too huge to make a dent in? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe while you're down there. If you're worried that graphene is still too expensive and hard to make to fulfill its promises, good news. Scientists accidentally found out how to make it cheaper, and Trace tells you all about that right here. Thank you guys for watching Seeker.